Accepting fate is a characteristic feature of the philosophical doctrine called the Stoa, to which Seneca belonged. According to the Stoics, fate equals nature, and mankind is part of nature. Resistance against this fate is completely unreasonable. What is the use, they say, to protest against the natural order or reason? Wisdom is to desire what fate forces you to have. A wise person switches off his emotions in order to accomplish this, because having emotions attests to unreasonable resistance. Seneca's ideal is to be free of all passions, apathy. Seneca is a driven statesman, just as most Stoics. After all, the road of nature or reason isn't only relevant to individuals, but to the state as well. The fact that his prescriptions for a virtuous and sober lifestyle are in strong contrast with his personal wealth grates a little, by the way. Seneca's writings display what is now called classical humanism. This is especially clear in his Letters to Lucilius. In these letters, he advises a young friend on issues of everyday life, from friendship to the judgment of the masses. Seneca praises Lucilius because of the human way he deals with slaves. Seneca considers this to be his credit and thinks it shows his philosophical maturation. It is important to deal with subordinates in the same way as you want your bosses to deal with you. In addition to this, Seneca considers slavery to be a relative term. Somebody who is not officially a slave can still be a slave of his ambition, his lusts, or his fears. Also, if nature determines our fate, it is possible for every free man to become a slave one day. Therefore, there is no natural reason to feel you are better than your slaves or your subordinates. This way, by emphasizing fate and nature, the Stoics express, at least in its embryonic state, the idea that every person is equal. In his time, this was previously unheard of. The way Seneca dies shows us much about his doctrine. Nero, Rome's cruel emperor, forces his former teacher Seneca to commit suicide because he suspects that Seneca has been involved in a plot to kill him. He bases this just on rumors. Nero's punishment shows how paranoid he is, but Seneca accepts his fate, reportedly without flinching. He drains the poisoned cup. An honorable death, as Socrates died the same way.